What's up? Today we're gonna color grade some 8-bit drone footage and make this footage look like this in post. Yeah, I think that's pretty cool. So yeah, today I'm gonna show you how you can do it as well. But first of all, what's the difference between 8-bit and 10-bit footage? Actually, it's quite simple. 8-bit footage has much less color information than 10-bit footage, which means you can manipulate the colors with a 10-bit image much better than with an 8-bit image. But does that mean that like an 8-bit image is unusable just because it's 8-bit and not 10-bit? Not really, because 8-bit is oftentimes more than enough, more than you ever need for social media or for web purposes anyway. Much more important than how much bit your image has is your light, your composition, and the story you're gonna tell. First of all, you gotta get the basics right. And the basics are like light, composition, and story. And these things are much more important than how much bit depth your image has. But with that being said, let's jump into Premiere Pro behind me. That is the wrong side, behind me, at my MacBook, and I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna color grade an 8-bit drone footage from the Mavic Air 2. Not the Air 2S, but just the Air 2. And I'm also gonna compare it to like a 10-bit image which I've shot from the Air 2S, which is a drone which is filming in 10-bit, and I'm gonna show you a little bit the comparison there as well. So let's go. So yeah, here we are in Premiere Pro in the color tab, and I've already edited this image beforehand, so don't be confused like here it is, here is the final edit. But I'm gonna show you how you can do it like from scratch basically. First of all, you're gonna go to your image, then you're gonna go into your like into your project window. You're gonna click this icon, new item, and you're gonna choose the adjustment layer. You're gonna set OK and drag that over your footage. And then your adjustment layer is gonna basically affect everything that's lying, oh my gosh, it's gonna affect everything that's right underneath it. So we are in the color tab already, that's good. And I'm gonna hit Lumetri Scopes so I can see what I'm working with. I'm gonna choose 8-bit for this case, and I'm gonna click on the adjustment layer to color grade of footage. First of all, I'm gonna do a color correction, and afterwards I'm gonna put a LUT on there, which is then the color grade in this case. This is my workflow. There are obviously better workflows, or there may be better workflows, and yeah, this is just my opinion, my workflow. Let's just leave it at that. First of all, I like to look at the waveform RGB, which I don't know why it isn't showing it me. There it is. So first of all, I like to look at the Lumetri scope, and here we see we have values from 100 to 0. 0 is all black, 100 is all white. If I pull this up, everything goes up. If I pull this down, everything goes down. So what we wanna do is we wanna stretch the image as far across this like the space from top to bottom as we can without clipping any highlights or shadows. The first thing I'm gonna do is set my white balance if it hasn't been set correctly in camera, which you should do anyway. So I set it correctly in camera so I don't have to do it in post. And I'm gonna reduce the blacks to pull these down. I can go -100. And I'm gonna pull the shadows down as well because I want to stretch the image like really far. There we go. Now we have a better contrast, and also the saturation is increasing because we are creating contrast. If we were to like increase the shadows, we would lose saturation because we would decrease the contrast. So put the shadows down if you want more color basically. And now I'm gonna go with the whites so that they barely touch the top. Something like this is pretty cool. And then I'm gonna work with the highlights a bit, make it a bit more brighter. And because it's also log footage, I'm gonna increase the saturation by a little bit, like +10. Then I'm gonna go into my curves and I'm gonna do some contrast. I'm gonna put a point in the shadows, put a point in the highlights, put a point into the midtones, pull down shadows even more because we want to stretch the image on the Lumetri scopes all the way down. Not too much, maybe something like this is enough. Look, you don't have to go down always, because sometimes if I were to go down all the way down right here, it would look horrible in my opinion, and we don't want that. So I'm gonna just go as far down as I think it still looks good. Something like this is pretty cool. And then I'm gonna pull up the highlights a little bit, pull down the midtones to flatten the curve a bit. Yeah, I know, I'm gonna put some Rona references right here. And this is before the curve, this is after the curve. Pretty good in my opinion. Now I also want to put a vignette on the image. What I'm gonna do now is duplicate this layer right here, the footage, with Option or Alt on your keyboard and drag it up. Then I'm gonna go into the effects and I'm gonna search for Lumetri color. And I'm gonna put this effect onto my footage. Go to effect controls, go to basic correction, and I'm gonna do exposure minus one. Of course, we're gonna now affect the whole image, which we don't want. So I'm gonna do a mask, drag it out all the way across the image, and also feather it out like to at least 1000% right here. And I'm gonna invert it because I want to have the vignette outside, like this. Now if I turn that off and on, let's make it a little bit bigger so you can see better. If I turn it off and on, we have a nice vignette, which adds something to the image. Now I'm gonna track my mask because we have camera movement, like we have a camera movement, and I want the vignette to stick. What I'm gonna do is track the mask real quick. I'm gonna fast forward this process for you so you don't have to get bored. So yeah, that's basically it. The mask is tracking and it's staying locked on the mountain. This is how it looks, and I think that looks really nice now. And see, just like this, you can create like a really nice looking 8-bit image. You don't have to have a 10-bit drone or 10-bit camera to create a good looking image, because I have a 10-bit drone, which is the Air 2S, and I think like this is a 10-bit image, and if I were to color create it, it would look like this. In my opinion, the image on the Air 2S looks better, but it's not like a huge difference. That's mainly because the light and the composition and the camera movement were like the main factors that are deciding on how good the image in the end is. Maybe I would like reduce the highlights a little bit to around 40 or something like that to make it not that white. But in my opinion, the 10-bit image looks better. But for 99% of use cases, an 8-bit image with good lighting and good composition works fine. Let's just put it like that. With an 8-bit image with great light and great composition, you can get some really good results. And with a 10-bit image with great light and a great composition, you can get some incredible results. But the 8-bit image will cover 99% of most use cases you'll ever come across. So should you really invest in a 10-bit image? I don't know, I think you should invest into learning composition and learning light, understanding light, using light the right way. So yeah, that's it. That's how you can get from an image like this now to an image that looks like this. And this is all just an 8-bit image, and you can get some pretty good results if you're like me and if you're like a lot of other really good artists that are like, I'm not trying to say I'm a really good artist, but what I'm trying to say is that if you focus on good light, on good composition, on a good story, and if you don't go too crazy with your color grading, you can get some pretty nice results and some pretty good results that
that will like work in 99% of use cases. So you don't really need 10-bit. And yeah, that's basically it. I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye.